Good afternoon. I'm Dr. Wojciech Marlicz from the Department of Gastroenterology, Pomeranian Medical University, Szczecin, Poland. And I'd like to discuss the paper, which is to be published in Mayo Clinic Proceedings, titled Non-steroidal Anti-Inflammatory Drugs, Proton Pump Inhibitors, and Gastrointestinal Injury, Contrasting Interactions in the Stomach and Small Intestine. This paper is co-authored by Dr. Wonieski, Dr. Grimes, and Dr. Quigley. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, and proton pump inhibitors, PPIs, are most commonly prescribed groups of drugs worldwide. The use of these drugs has increased dramatically over the last 20 years. These drugs are very often heavily advertised for different GI and non-GI related maladies and are available over the counter at the pharmacy without any referral and any prescription. The use of NSAIDs has been associated with many side effects outside of the GI tract, like increased risk of cardiovascular disease, but also the injury of gastrointestinal mucosa. The most serious side effect is bleeding from the peptic ulcer disease. Therefore, societies of gastroenterology, rheumatology or cardiology advocate prescribing PPI along the NSAID therapy, especially in people at risk with the past history of GI bleeding, peptic ulcer disease, or older people taking one antiplatelet drug in combination with anticoagulants, bisphosphonates, serotonin reuptake inhibitors, or steroids. The pathomechanism of NSAID's injury in the small intestine is different than in the stomach and is involving acid-independent pathways like lipoxygenase and bile acids. But recent concepts of the injury of the small intestine caused by NSAIDs revolve around microbiota alterations. Microbiota altered by NSAIDs induce the innate immunity system and evoke pro-inflammatory cascade leading to mucosal breaks, erosions, lacerations, which can be nicely seen in capsule endoscopy or enteroscopic studies. Co-therapy of PPI is not protective against injury in the small bowel caused by NSAIDs. In fact, it has been nicely shown in animal models that the chronic use of PPI is associated with reduction of beneficial bacteria, especially actinobacteria or bifidobacteria. The small bowel injury and microbiota alterations can also lead to a phenomenon called metabolic endotoxemia. And metabolic endotoxemia has been associated with worsening of several clinical conditions like chronic kidney disease or cardiovascular disease or liver disease, has the potential to influence the central nervous system and, for instance, lower the threshold of pain or can exacerbate the irritable bowel syndrome or inflammatory bowel disease. Recent data also points toward unwanted effect of microbiota alterations in patients undergoing chemotherapy in some cancers. Therefore, protecting the small bowel mucosa, especially in chronic NSAID and PPI use, is very important. The antibiotic administration and modulation of microbiota by these agents has proved to be beneficial. However, chronic use of antibiotics carry the risk of generating microbial resistant strains. Therefore, novel therapies are urgently looked for. And such hope is offered by probiotic administration with the potential to modulate the gastrointestinal microbiota. And it has been shown in various animal and clinical studies that probiotics have the potential to protect the mucosa in patients taking chronically NSAIDs and PPIs. And our home take message is to prescribe these drugs based on evidence-based medicine and use the lowest possible dose for the shortest possible period of time in a given clinical condition. And the special attention should be paid to patients who are older, who are immunocompromised, who are hospitalized, especially at risk with C. difficile infection. And also prescribing probiotics might be beneficial in reducing the symptoms generated by these drugs, like irritable bowel syndrome, and have the potential to protect the gastrointestinal mucosa. Thank you very much for your attention.
We hope you found this presentation from the content of Mayo Clinic Proceedings valuable. Our journal's mission is to promote the best interests of patients by advancing the knowledge and professionalism of the physician community. If you are interested in more information about us, our homepage is www.mayoclinicproceedings.org. There you will find access information for our social media content, such as additional videos on our YouTube channel or journal updates on Facebook. You can also follow us on Twitter. More information about healthcare at Mayo Clinic is available at www.mayoclinic.com. This video content is copyrighted by Mayo Foundation for Medical Education and Research.